Hello, everyone. This is meteorologist Dave Snyder at the Anchorage, Alaska National Weather Service Forecast Office TV Desk. Your response to last week's extended forecast and climate post told us you're interested in more information about Alaska's extended weather pattern. So here's an update on the current mid-October weather pattern and where we're going as we head toward the end of October. This is what we'd consider to be a normal October jet stream pattern or storm track for Alaska. When you compare it to where we've been this week, you'll see the sharp shift in the pattern, more of a south to north flow, making strong connections to the subtropics and the West Pacific, where an active typhoon season is still ongoing. Impacts from the remnants of typhoons have been a notable feature of this week's pattern. Several periods of high winds were noted over the Alaska Range, the Upper Kuskokwim Valley, and the Anchorage area. The wind was a key ingredient in keeping temperatures above normal. In fact, Anchorage has had four consecutive days with record high minimum temperatures this week. When mid-October lows averaged near 30, lows have held in the mid-40s. On Wednesday, Fairbanks set a daily high of 53 degrees. The average high temperature is normally near freezing in mid-October. The record temperature of 53 degrees was the second highest temperature in the period from October 16th to March 15th since 1940, a period of the year that's usually dominated by much colder weather. Barrow tied the record high today at 35, set in 1981. The average high is 21. In the west and west central mainland, very wet conditions have been reported. Bethel and McGrath are already the fourth wettest October of record. Caltag has recorded over 5 inches of rain this month, certainly one of their wettest Octobers as well. Most lower elevation locations in the interior and northwest that have had snow cover have lost it. The average date for establishing the permanent winter snow cover is about October 10 in Bettles. Today, October 18, is the normal date in Fairbanks. It will soon be later than normal in the southern interior of Alaska. The expected pattern for October 24 to 31 will change somewhat, with a ridge of high pressure dropping south toward the Pacific Northwest. However, there is more uncertainty in this pattern compared to our high confidence last week. This slight pattern shift will allow the connection to the wettest air, or the path of the atmospheric rivers, to remain more over south-central and northern southeast Alaska, and allow the west coast to be somewhat drier this week, which should put the focus for above-average precipitation over the Yukon-Kuskokwim Delta and especially the northern Gulf Coast, with slightly above-normal precipitation over the interior and north. Chances are good that temperatures will remain well above normal around the entire state this period, but daily temperatures will still fall, as decreasing daylight will have the greatest impact on sensible weather. Make no mistake, daily temperatures will be colder than last week. Winter, snow, and sub-freezing temperatures are crucial to the Alaska way of life this time of year. We expect this continued warmer-than-normal pattern to create issues for transportation and subsistence hunting in the west and interior. This map of Alaska shows cities and villages not connected to the Alaska highway system. They're seen as red dots. With most of Alaska existing off the road system, snow cover and river freeze-up is crucial for moving supplies around the state. In south-central, the high water table will continue to keep low-lying areas and basements flooded. Wind stress on trees and buildings will continue, and power outages remain a threat. For southeast, flooding chances will continue as the snow level remains very high. Unfrozen ground may lead to downed trees, creating power outages if wind threats develop there. For aviators, icing and turbulence issues will be a factor over south central and southeast during this period. Remember, this is a broad look at a developing weather pattern 6 to 10 days in advance, and individual storms are only well forecast several days in advance. This information is not meant to be specific, so you should continue to monitor information from the National Weather Service offices in Anchorage, Fairbanks, and Juneau in the coming days for watches, warnings, and advisories. You can do that by going to weather.gov, using your NOAA weather radio, or tuning into the Alaska Weather Show each day, or your favorite local TV and radio stations. Thanks for sharing this message with your Alaska weather friends, and let us know about the impacts you're seeing in your community. This is National Weather Service meteorologist Dave Snyder, and thanks for watching.